And here is the Writer's Almanac for Monday. It's the 6th of July, 2020.
1885, on this day, Louis Pasteur successfully tested his rabies vaccine on a 9-year-old boy named Joseph Meister, who had been bitten by a rabid dog. It's the birthday of the artist Frida Kahlo, born just outside Mexico City, 1907, painter who said, "Critics thought I was a surrealist, but I wasn't. I never painted dreams. I painted my own reality." It was on this day in 1928, the first full-length talking picture, The Lights of New York, premiered at the Strand Theater in New York City, the first 100% talking picture. Al Jolson's The Jazz Singer had come out earlier, but it had only brief intervals of sound. 1896, William Sidney Porter, whom we know as O. Henry, fled from Texas to escape charges of embezzlement. He'd worked at a bank. His father-in-law posted bail for him, but Porter fled first to New Orleans and then to Honduras, lay low for a while, and then he got word that his wife was dying of tuberculosis, and he returned to Texas, turned himself in. He served 3 years of a 5-year sentence, during which time he wrote and sold adventure stories to support his daughter, Margaret, who had no idea that her dad was in prison. She was just told that he was away on business. Porter was released from prison for good behavior in 1901, moved to New York, continued writing stories, wrote about one per week, and published his first collection, Cabbages and Kings, in 1904. It's the birthday of the author Hilary Mantel, born in Derbyshire, England, 1952. She had already written several novels and a memoir and a collection of stories when she published Wolf Hall in 2009, a historical novel about the life of Thomas Cromwell, the advisor to Henry VIII. She won the Booker Prize for that book and then won the prize again for the sequel, Bring Up the Bodies, 3 years later. One of the judges called her the greatest living English prose writer. And today is the birthday of the 14th Dalai Lama, born in Tibet in 1935 to a farm family. His mother gave birth to him on a straw mat in a cow shed behind the family hut. When he was 2 years old, a search team decided that he was the reincarnation of the 13th Dalai Lama. When he was 23, he fled Tibet to escape the Chinese army, which had brought the country back under Chinese rule. Fled on foot to India, where he's lived ever since as a refugee in Dharamsala. Here's a poem for today by Ted Kooser at the cancer clinic. She is being helped toward the open door that leads to the examining rooms by two young women I take to be her sisters. Each bends to the weight of an arm and steps with the straight, tough bearing of courage. At what must seem to be a great distance, a nurse holds the door, smiling and calling encouragement. How patient she is in the crisp white sails of her clothes. The sick woman peers from under her funny knit cap to watch each foot swing, scuffing forward and take its turn under her weight. There is no restlessness or impatience or anger anywhere in sight. Grace fills the clean mold of this moment, and all the shuffling magazines grow still. At the Cancer Clinic, a poem by Ted Kooser from Delights and Shadows. That's the Writer's Almanac for Monday, July the 6th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.